a very important point is being made by Prabhupada, that how the Supreme Lord cannot be captured by our material attempts. Just like Hiranyaksha, with his material strength, now wanted to capture the Supreme Lord. Earlier he wanted to kill him with his weapons and everything, not understanding that the Supreme Lord cannot be killed. And now he wanted to at least capture him with his arms. So he, with his strong arms, he went to embrace the Lord. So where the Lord was standing. And then to his amazement, he found that the Lord is standing outside of his arms. So Prabhupada explains here some very beautiful points. First, Prabhupada explains about that the Lord here, he is called as Keshava. The Lord was called Keshava because in his Leela, as the original Supreme Personality of Godhead, Govinda, as Krishna, when the Lord appeared 5,000 years back in Vrindavan, the Lord, he killed Keshi demon. So he is called by the name Keshava. So here we find, even though the Supreme Lord has taken the form of a boar, he is still addressed as Keshava, the killer of demon Keshi. That means Lord Varaha is non-different from the Supreme Lord Krishna, and the Supreme Lord Krishna is the origin of all these different incarnations of the Lord. So Prabhupada is mentioning that point from Brahma Samhita, that Krishna, the Supreme Lord, he is the origin not only of every living entities, not only of the devatas, just like in Bhagavad Gita Krishna says, Aham Adir Hi Devanam, right? And Krishna, Aham Veera Pradapitaha, he is the origin of all living entities. Not only that, he is the origin of all different incarnations of the Lord. So even the different incarnations, he is Govindam Adi Purusham Sarvakarana Karanam. He is the cause of all causes. So this is the first very important point which Prabhupada is pointing out, that the Lord here is called as Keshava. In this verse, the Lord is addressed as Keshava because he killed the demon Keshi in the beginning of creation. Keshava is also the name of Krishna. Krishna is the origin of all incarnations. And it is confirmed in Brahma Samhita that Govinda, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the cause of all causes, exists simultaneously in his different incarnations and expansions. So the Supreme Lord, in his original form as Krishna, even though he stays in Goloka Vrindavan Dham, but simultaneously the Lord exists in his varieties of different incarnations. Even though the Supreme Lord stays in Goloka Vrindavan, but his incarnations come in the material world, and sometimes the Supreme Lord also personally descends in this material world. So this is one very important point. Another important point which Prabhupada is pointing out is about this demon's attempt to capture the Supreme Lord with his arms, with his mighty arms. So Prabhupada is pointing this out. The demon's attempt to measure the Supreme Personality of Godhead is significant. So actually, when he wants to capture, that means he is thinking that the Lord is limited, he can be captured, his length and breadth can be measured. So this is akin to the modern scientists who also think that the creation of the Lord, or the Lord, whatever people may think, the nature or whatever, it is all measurable, right? We can, with our advancement of scientific understanding, we can measure the length and breadth of everything. We can find out what is the cause of this creation. So Prabhupada is saying, this is an attempt by demon-like Hiranyaksha. So what did he do? Demon wanted to embrace him with his arms, thinking that with his limited arms, he could capture the absolute by material power. So then Prabhupada points out what he could not understand. This foolish demon could not understand. The Lord can be greater than the greatest, and he can become smaller than the smallest. So in his Varaha form, the Lord was, you know, very heavily built up. And Hiranyaksha was also akin in that direction, that he was also very bodily, you know, very, very strong, very tall features, everything. So he was thinking that I will be able to capture this Varaha Murti. So Prabhupada explained, the foolish could not understand that the Lord can be great and at the same time he can become smaller than the smallest and come out of his embracement of the arm which he wanted to capture the Lord. So God is the greatest of the great and smallest of the small. So we all know in Vedic literature it is said, Anor Aniyam Mahato Mahiyam. He is greater than the greatest and he can be smaller than the smallest. No one can capture the Supreme Lord or bring him under his control. But the demoniac persons always attempts to measure the length and the breadth of the Supreme Lord. So then Prabhupada explains a very beautiful concept, that how actually by no amount of material strength, by no amount of material intelligence, by no amount of material endeavor, it is possible to capture the Supreme Lord. So Prabhupada explains, Krishna, when Arjuna wanted to see his bigger than the biggest form, Krishna manifested that form, universal form, to Arjuna. So much so that Arjuna became terrified seeing such a gigantic form. He was not able to measure the limit of that form. He was saying, my dear Lord, how many unlimited hands you have got? How many unlimited legs you have got? Unlimited mouths you have got? I am unable to measure the length and breadth of this form. Where it begins, where it starts, where is the middle, where is the end, I cannot figure out. So Prabhupada is saying, if a devotee, Arjuna, could not figure out the length and the breadth of the Lord, where it is possible for a demoniac person, isn't it, to calculate or to capture or to control the Supreme Lord? But that same Supreme Lord who could manifest his universal form before Arjuna, that same Supreme Lord, he can become controlled, he can become measured with loving devotional service. Just like we see, the Lord became captured by the love of Mother Yashoda. She was able to capture him, of course, with love. Even though materially she also tried to bind him with the rope. So Prabhupada explains, the Lord cannot be bound with ordinary ropes. He can be bound only with love. So finally, out of love and affection, the Lord agreed to be bound by Mother Yashoda. So that is possible only. The Lord can be controlled only by love. Similarly, Prabhupada is giving an example, another beautiful example, that out of His grace, out of His mercy, that same Supreme Lord, He can become measured and He can be kept in a small box. So there are many devotees of the Lord that when they travel from different places, they are able to take the Lord in their hand. At one place we are seeing immeasurable form of the Lord in the form of universal form, and out of love and out of His mercy, the Lord can become packed up in a small box and interact with His devotee. When for a long time Prabhupada had kept away His Radha Govinda deities in His small box, in the dream, sometime Prabhupada used to dream, the Lord is telling him, why have you kept me in the box? Take me out and worship me. And then finally Prabhupada took him out from the box and he started worshipping. Right? We find in the example of Sanatana Goswami, he used to carry the Lord in his small cloth wherever he would go, because he had no house. He had no place to build an altar for the Lord. So sometime when he would be sitting under a tree, he would hang the Lord on the tree with his cloth. You see. And we can see the interaction of the devotees with the Lord. How the Lord becomes completely, practically dependent on the devotee. And when Sanatana Goswami is eating his chapati, and when he is offering to the Lord is demanding, what are you doing? Every day, at least one day you give me with ghee. Every day you are giving me basi chapati. You know. And Sanatana Goswami is saying, my dear Lord, today you are asking. So the Lord is saying, at least give me some salt. You give me only chapati. Today you are asking salt, tomorrow you will say, give me some ghee. My dear Lord, be satisfied. I am a mendicant. That is what I can give you. Be satisfied with that. Of course, when time came, Sanatana Goswami, because he had a desire, he wanted to serve the Lord properly. But that was his position at that time. The Lord accepted his service at that time. But when the Lord inspired somebody, some big businessman, he came. And then he built a huge palace for the Lord. And that is what we see. Very big temple, Madan Mohan temple was built. You see. So this is another feature of the Lord. That a devotee, the Lord can become packed up in a small box of his devotee and he can carry him anywhere. So he is Mahato Mahiyan Anoraniyan. Once, Prabhupada relates a very interesting incident about universal form of the Lord. This very, very devastating form of the Lord. So devotees ask this question to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, why Arjuna became afraid by seeing universal form of the Lord? Why it is that devatas, all the devatas, they became afraid, including Arjuna, frightened seeing this universal form of the Lord? So Prabhupada replied, because they cannot love Vishwarupa. You see? Then Prabhupada is asking, if Krishna comes before you as Vishwarupa, can you love him? Then Prabhupada is giving an example. Suppose your father is police inspector, and instead of coming in his original relationship, loving relationship with you as a father, suppose he comes from his office firing bullets in the house. As a police officer he comes, in his position if he comes, Prabhupada says his son will forget loving him. His own son will forget loving him. You see. So then Prabhupada relates that of course a devotee does recognize that this is a ghastly form of the Lord, but this is the form of the Lord. This is one of the form of the Lord. Of course it's a temporary form of the Lord. The whole universe is his body. It is just like we develop an external body, the soul develops an external body. The super soul's external body is this whole universe manifestation. That is his universal body. So, Prabhupada relates very nicely that in 1942, when there was a war between India, I think it was between India and Pakistan, or no? Sorry, some war was there. I think World War II, I think, because that India and Pakistan was after 47. So it was a world war. So at that time, Prabhupada relates the governments, they had given a message that whenever there is a siren, whenever there is a warning given, they should all go inside the bunkers. And Prabhupada relates how there were sirens and bombs were falling like anything. So very beautifully Prabhupada explains. And then Prabhupada says, I was reminded of Krishna's universal form. That yes, this war, this ghastly war which is going on, this is also another feature of the Lord. When Arjuna asked this universal form, who are you? What is this form you have manifested? Please explain to me. Krishna said, Kalosmi. I am that devastating form of Kala. And I have come to take away, to devour all these demoniac personalities. So it's a very beautiful conversation, Prabhupada explains. I remember in 1942, December, date I forget, I was just eating and there were siren of bombing in Calcutta. So in Calcutta bombing was going on and there were sirens. So the arrangement was, as soon as there will be siren or bombing, government selected some places, shelters. This room in the house, shelter room. So we had to go into the shelter room and bombing began. Gong, gong. So we were seeing Vishwarupa, you see, at that time. I was thinking that this is also Krishna's another form. But this form is not very lovable form. This form is not very lovable. So devotee in love wants to love Krishna in his original form. This Vishwarupa is not his original form. He can appear in any form, that is his all potency. But the lovable form is Krishna Shyama Sundara. See? So, this is very important point which Prabhupada relates. Then Prabhupada explains another important understanding about how. So actually if you see, this is Mahato Mahiyam, one of the very big forms of the Supreme Lord. So Prabhupada explains, let us think, suppose if you wanted to love Krishna, so Prabhupada is saying actually we have to love the original form of Krishna, Shyam Sundara form, right? Now, neither it is possible for us to worship the Vishwarupa form, to love that Vishwarupa form, because that's a ghastly form of the Lord. Even Arjuna became afraid. So where is the question of performing loving devotional service with Vishwarupa form? Neither it is possible to see the original Shyam Sundara form of the Lord because our eyes are materially contaminated. So we are conditioned soul. Until and unless we become completely purified, Yam Shyam Sundaram Achintya Guna Swarupam, that Shyam Sundara form of Krishna we will not be able to see. So Prabhupada explains, that is why Archa Vigraha form of the Lord is a mercy form of the Lord. Neither you can worship Vishwarupa form, nor you can see the original 200 form of Krishna, His Sachidananda, original form of the Lord. But His merciful form as Archa Vigraha, we can see that form of the Lord. And Prabhupada explains, do not think that these are some idol and this form is different from His original form. No. It is completely spiritual. It is absolute. There is no difference. It is as good as serving the original personality of Godhead. You see? It is His mercy form by which He has appeared, so that even in our material contaminated state, we can still worship Him according to the directions given by the spiritual master. So this is very interesting, very important to understand. So Prabhupada is saying in one of His lectures, this temple is meant for that purpose, that people will come and see the deity. The deity is Krishna. Don't think otherwise. So what is this temple meant for? It's a chance given for the people to come and see the beautiful form of the Lord decorated in the temple. The idea is, when they see the beautifully formed, decorated form of the Lord, they will forget material dressing. People want to be decorated themselves in the material world and attract others. When they see the beautiful dressed form of the Lord, they will forget this material dressing. So Prabhupada is relating further how this is such a merciful form of the Lord. Prabhupada says, in this form as Krishna, He has agreed to be dressed by you. And then Prabhupada is relating, suppose you want to be a devotee and you wanted this loving devotional service, you wanted to dress the Lord. Is it possible that you can dress the Vishwarupa form of the Lord? Suppose the Lord had come before you as Vishwarupa, Prabhupada is saying all your mills of the world will be insufficient. You'll not be able to make such a cloth, such a dress for the Lord in His Vishwarupa form. It's not possible. Or Prabhupada is relating, suppose you wanted to offer something to the Lord. Is it possible to offer to Vishwarupa form of the Lord? You see, what is He eating? He is devouring the whole world. Prabhupada is saying, He is devouring the whole world. Where you are going to feed Him? He can devour the whole world. So it is not possible. So Krishna comes in the form of Archa Vigraha and He is saying, do not worry. Even if you offer me one Tulsi Patra, that is also sufficient. According to your means, you offer me. And then Prabhupada is saying, okay, somebody will think, temple is too far for me, or I cannot build a huge temple. Then Prabhupada is saying, even that does not matter. The Lord becomes agreed to be even kept in your small box. Even if you cannot visit the temple, take the deities with you. Wherever you go, you can offer Him patram, pushpam, phalam, toyam, yo mad bhakta prayachati. Tad aham ashnami, Krishna is saying, I will accept. But of course, Prabhupada relates very beautifully. Prabhupada is saying, not that you have all the means with you and for yourself you are making all kachoris and pakodas and everything, and to Krishna you are offering patram, pushpam, phalam. You see, Krishna is more intelligent, it's more clever. And not that for you, you are building a huge palatial building and you want to keep Krishna in a small box. No, Krishna is very intelligent. That is all according to the means. If we don't have means, if we have means, we should build a gorgeous, beautiful temple for the Lord. And if we don't have means, then the Lord is agreeable. Okay, I can be in your small box, you can carry me anywhere, and I will accept even patram, pushpam, phalam, purim, whatever you offer. So actually, this deity form of the Lord is a mercy incarnation, the archa form of the Lord. So there is one nice conversation, Prabhupada's. I will just read this, it's very beautiful. Prabhupada is saying, real thing is bhaktya. Therefore it is said, bhaktya puman jata viraga endriyat. The more you serve Krishna, you give Krishna to eat, you give Krishna to be dressed nicely, then what will happen? Prabhupada is saying, jata viraga endriyat. Automatically you will become detached, viraga, from indriya, sense gratification. The more we serve Krishna, the more we dress Krishna, the more lovingly we offer to Krishna, we will become free from sensual attractions automatically. So Krishna comes personally, exhibits this Krishna Murti. Just like here is the picture of your spiritual master. You worship this picture, you know, this is my spiritual master's picture. Similarly, if somebody disregards this picture, you will not tolerate. Similarly, Krishna's deity and Krishna not different. See? So Krishna's deity and Krishna, they are non-different. I was explaining this morning, Krishna has come kindly to accept your service as you can deal with him. So we should be very careful. Prabhupada is explaining. Krishna has very mercifully come so that we can handle him lovingly. This is very important. In one of his lectures, Prabhupada explains, if this mentality you forget, if this understanding you forget, that it is by mercy the Lord has appeared as Archa Vigraha to accept our services. If you forget this understanding, and if you think that actually this is some doll or this is some stone or this is some metal, if you come to that understanding and then you think, let me offer whatever I can, let me offer some rotten flower to the Lord, then what will happen? Krishna will not protest. In the form of deity, he will not protest. The protest will come in the form of our devastation of spiritual life. See? So we have to be very careful. In Nama Aparad, there are only 10 offenses to be avoided. In Vigraha Aparad, there are 64 offenses are there. See? So it has to be understood very properly that with lot of care and attention, we should actually take care of their lordships. So Prabhupada is saying, if Krishna comes in his gigantic form, as it was shown to Arjuna, you will not be able to capture him. Neither you have any means to dress him. Suppose the universal form of Krishna is there and you dress him, whole cloth factory will be finished. Is it not? How you can dress? You have no capacity to dress. But Krishna has kindly accepted a form, the deity. You can purchase cloth according to your means. And with great devotion, you can dress him. Gigantic form, Virat Rupa form, that you cannot. You see? So, this is what we should understand. Then, in another place, Prabhupada explains, Bhaktya tutosha Bhagavan gajayutha paya. The example is Gajendra, elephant. It was not even a human being. Now how is he satisfied? You have seen that picture. Here I don't find that picture in my apartment. That a calf is by the side of Krishna and he's trying to lick up the body of Krishna like this. And Krishna is embracing immediately. So Prabhupada is explaining what that animal has got. No education, no strength, right? No beauty, nothing of that sort. Simply he has got the feeling, my Lord, I love you. See? So actually this feeling is more important. That is what is most essential part of devotional service. Bhajatam Priti Purvakam. Bhajana is not just mechanical, it is with Priti. That should not be missing. That is very important item. So, further I'll just read one more last, very interesting, Prabhupada is saying. Anywhere you can worship Krishna, you can keep in a box. It does not mean you must have a very big temple. That is according to me. If you have got money, build temple. Just like we have got in Bombay, Vrindavan. If money comes, then otherwise, keep in a box. Krishna is agreeable. Krishna does not say, first of all, build a big temple, then I will accept your service. So Krishna is not saying, he's not demanding. First you build me a huge temple, then only I'm going to accept your service. No. Patram, pushpam, phalam, simply devotion. Real thing is bhakti. Either you keep in a box or big temple, if you have got means to build big temple, then don't keep him in a box. See, if you have got a means to build a big temple, then don't keep in the box. He is agreeable. Keep him in a box. Devotion to Krishna cannot be checked in any circumstances. You can keep anywhere very peacefully. Worship the deity, small scale, big scale, no problem. See? If there is no temple, you can keep a small deity in a small box and open it. After taking bath, sit down. Offer him little patram, pushpam, phalam, toyam. Little you can offer. Little water. What is the difficulty? Deity worship. You can worship deity anywhere. In a small box, you can keep the deity. After taking bath, you offer something. If you have nothing to offer, offer a little tulsi or any leaf. That Krishna says, patram, pushpam, phalam, toyam. Real thing is whether you are lover and devotee. Then Krishna will accept anything you offer. It is not that you have to cook very sumptuously, very rich food. Then Krishna you will offer. Krishna is not after your food. Krishna is after your devotion and faith. That can be created anywhere if you are actually sincere. So we'll stop with this. Grantara Srimad Bhagavatam Ki Jai. Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada.